Hey, how's it going, guys? It's Nate here. And Fallout 4 is a game that offers the player, well, let's just say, a few options when it comes to instruments of offense and defense. About 3 weeks ago, I uploaded a video exploring 5 of the game's most fun, creative, or otherwise just fascinating, rare or overlooked weapons that many players have little to no idea about. And that video got a pretty great response. Like, not only in views, but the comments were really nice too, and I had a great time making it. Lucky us, there's still quite a few fantastical ballistic and melee weapons that we just couldn't fit into that previous upload, and many of your comments frankly brought a few new ones to my attention that before I had no idea about. So, you can probably already guess what the agenda is today. Sit back, maybe grab a bowl of sugar bombs and an ice cold Nuka-Cola, and relax as we dive right in to 5 more secret and unique weapons you may have missed in Fallout 4. We'll be kicking off our journey a long walk, or I suppose swim, away from the Commonwealth itself. Instead, honing in on the shores of Far Harbor. On this island, at an abandoned, now feral ghoul-infested logging mill, known on our map as Lake Echo Lumber, within a red steamer trunk located at the top of the site's largest building, the sole survivor can find the Harvester, a unique variant of the Ripper, a short, chainsaw-like item, originally developed as a general-purpose tool by the US military back when there still was a US military. What makes the Harvester so special, though, is its incredible legendary effect. You see, it comes with the staggering ability, which gives the item a, quote, chance to stagger an opponent with every hit. Now, this is in fact not an especially rare enchantment. Other staggering weapons exist across Fallout 4's Wasteland, but staggering has an especially interesting relationship with the Ripper in particular. You see, the Ripper has a fairly low damage output. Around 4-9 points of unarmored health per hit is what you can expect. However, its attack speed is insanely fast. Every second the Ripper is making contact with a target, it's delivering around 6-8 hits. In fact, in VATS, every time you use the Ripper, it delivers 7 hits. So, when you have an item with such an absurd rate of fire, combined with the staggering effect, giving you a 25-50% chance to stagger a foe every hit, it's pretty much going to render any enemy you use it against entirely helpless. Sure, not every blow is staggering them, but you're producing so many that it doesn't even matter. The Harvester will lock them in this constant staggering dance where they're unable to retaliate with an attack of their own, and can't even run away. All the while, you rapidly drain around 63 points of their health per second. Additionally, the right perks can make this already frankly overpowered blade an even more lethal tool. I've found that you'll be able to extract the most value out of the Harvester when going up against otherwise rather powerful enemies one-on-one. In the gameplay you're seeing on screen right now, you'll watch as I'm able to decimate some of the strongest creatures in the game that should be exceptionally challenging bosses such as fog crawlers by simply trapping them in corners. At times it feels borderline game-breaking, rendering what Bethesda clearly designed to be some of the toughest moments in Fallout 4 not so tough at all. Overall, the Harvester is a fun, creative, and strong machine-powered blade that any survivor should absolutely try to add to their arsenal. Next on our list, believe it or not, we're still staying away from the Commonwealth for now. Instead, we're gonna take a trip to the happiest place in the Wasteland, Nuka World, to inspect what is among the weirdest weapons in the entire game, the Acid Soaker. Already, you can see this thing looks a little strange, but before we start exploring its stats or any of her complexities, I should explain how we go about obtaining this high pH object, as it's acquired in a rather unorthodox way. Instead of finding it in a box, buying it from a merchant, or completing some quest, the Acid Soaker can only be purchased for 6,250 tickets from Nuka World's Nukacade. Not caps, mind you, arcade tickets. The Nukacade, for those of you uninitiated, functions pretty much as you would expect an arcade to, really. You use arcade tokens, which can be found across the park, purchased from certain vendors, or just traded in for using pre-war money, to play your pick of 5 different games, which reward you in tickets based off of your performance. Once you've managed to gather 6,250 of them, take your tickets to the prize machine, and you can redeem them for the Acid Soaker, among a few other interesting gifts. This is a truly unique weapon. It's not a variant or a vanilla one with a legendary effect slapped on like the Harvester. No, the Acid Soaker is truly one of a kind, with a custom appearance and all sorts of really interesting quirks. Indicated by its name and overall aesthetic, the Acid Soaker sprays acid at your foes, dealing an immediate 10 points of damage, and then proceeding to inflict a sort of lingering poison damage that will continue to harm your target for another 5 seconds. Usually, altogether, every shot you make will deal about 30 to 50 damage, depending on your foe's armor. In all honesty, from a sheer stats perspective, this is rather average at best. Its per-hit damage is fairly reasonable, but it takes a good few seconds for the Soaker to do all of the damage it needs to. Its time to kill just isn't that great in comparison to some other options. But it gets even weirder. Being a totally unique weapon, the Acid Soaker has a totally unique form of ammunition, a kind that can't be bought from merchants or produced at an ammunition plant. Instead, the Soaker uses what's called acid concentrate as ammo, and that can only be crafted at chemistry stations, and is ridiculously resource-intensive to make. A single unit of acid concentrate, which will allow you to fire one squirt, one, costs 20 acid, 2 adhesive, and 8 glass. Anyone familiar with crafting, and particularly settlement mode, understands this is just an insane set of requirements. And the fact that the ammo is just so costly to manufacture makes the Soaker even less practical than it already was, to the point where it's really just a novelty item. That said, boy is it not novel. Despite its shortcomings, the Soaker is undeniably a really cool collectible. The custom model and texture, based loosely off of the Deliverer's suppressed 5mm, with that cute little tank on top, looks great, and the effects when firing are a blast, pun intended, to observe. And that's the perfect summary of this oh-so-interesting sprayer of acid. A fun thing to look at, but not so much a useful thing to bring to battle. No matter, you should definitely check it out. Coming in at number 3, we have one of those objects that's most likely going to be really hard to acquire, as it doesn't have a set spawn location unlike the other 2 we've covered so far, but instead may only spawn in the inventories of legendary characters or merchants, which will happen very rarely, as there's an enormous pool of items those legendaries can drop from, essentially meaning that whether or not you get this item is all left up to an RNG deck that's heavily stacked against your favor. And no matter how hard we look, it's theoretically possible for this thing to never appear, like, at all in a game. But, nonetheless, I give you the never-ending double-barrel shotgun. So, similar to the staggering power we mentioned earlier, never-ending is an enchantment. Mind you, if you haven't noticed, I'm using the words enchantment and effect pretty interchangeably at this point, but I digress. Never-ending is an enchantment that can spawn or be found on a few other weapons. It essentially allows for the sole survivor to fire all of their ammunition from whatever item it's applied to without ever needing to reload. So, say you have 500 cells for a laser rifle. Well, normally you'd have to reload it after firing around 20 and put in another magazine or cell pack. With Never Ending, you'll be able to just straight up fire all 500 in succession. Well, as you might imagine, a never-ending double-barrel shotgun creates some really interesting results. Ignoring the obvious irony of a double-barrel item being allowed to fire hundreds of slugs without a reload, the thing that makes this really cool is the fact that the double barrel shotgun does not have a maximum rate of fire. It's one of the only arms in the game that theoretically allows us to fire rounds as fast as we can click our mouse. Now, normally this otherwise insane advantage is curbed by the fact that you can't fire more than twice with this item without needing to reload, which takes a few seconds, greatly limiting your potential damage per second. But what the never-ending effect is going to do is remove that limitation. And all of a sudden, our ability to theoretically fire infinite rounds a second isn't so theoretical. Combine this with the fact that the double barrel is already a pretty strong instrument, delivering a minimum of 45 points of damage with every shot, and you have yourself an exceptional item, as powerful as your trigger finger is fast. Further modifications and your own perk layout will of course only increase the appeal and efficiency of this item. In hindsight, the double barrel shotgun's greatest handicap is its reload speed and ammo capacity. And with those limitations removed, well, things, they can get pretty fun. So, if you ever find such a boomstick being sold by a merchant, or in the inventory of a legendary Deathclaw, be sure to hang on tight. For fourth spot, we're already heading back to Far Harbor's Island of Acadia. I know, that was fast. To look at Sergeant Ash. This is a legendary flamer variant that can be purchased from Dejean, one of the many runaway synths dug in at the island's observatory with Dima. There's no special process necessary for this one. Just walk right up to the guy and buy it. You don't even need to side with the synths in Far Harbor storyline. Just make sure they're not hostile to you. Oh, and equally important, make sure you have enough caps, because I must concede this puppy will be on the pricier side of things. The exact amount you'll end up paying varies based on your own character's level and specific build. Charisma points in particular matter here, but I ended up needing to fork over 1,656 caps for this projectable grill. And that was on a fairly high level character. So, with such a large cost, what's it getting us? Well, at first glance, not much. Sergeant Ash is statistically identical to a normal flamer in every single category except damage per hit, where it does a stunning 13 points compared to a generic's 12. Okay, so nothing spectacular, but it's of course the legendary effect that's going to heat things up. With every hit, the Ash gives us a 20% chance to cripple a target's legs. This may not initially seem like a big deal, but the way this enchantment interacts with the item itself is quite similar to the Harvester and the Stagger effect we mentioned earlier, as the Flamer, likewise, has an exceedingly fast rate of fire at around 6 to 8 hits per second. So just 2 seconds of concentrated fire on an enemy, no pun intended, is almost guaranteed to cripple their legs. And crippled legs basically mean that your foe will be unable to move at all until you finish them off. Certain human, synth, and super mutant characters, which rely on firearms and whatnot, will still be able to take shots at you while they're wounded. But melee attack only NPCs, such as feral ghouls, deathclaws, etc., will be totally incapacitated by this, turning some of the game's most fearsome baddies into not much of a problem at all. Where, oh where have we seen this before? Bear in mind, you'll also be doing roughly 100 points of damage a second with this Inferno. And on top of that, even more with the right mods and perks. I honestly loving this thing. Cooking the raiders and ghouls of the Commonwealth to a well-done state is satisfying enough in its own right. But with this weapon, it's not even difficult. Now, aside from being both enjoyable and effective to use, Sergeant Ash also carries a bit of an Easter egg meaning, as the Flamer's name is in fact a reference to Sergeant Bash, a robot prominently featured in the British robot fighting show Robot Wars, which was known for its use of a flamethrower in combat. To my knowledge, the robot wasn't crippling any other robot's knees, but still, a fun little fact. So, you get a powerful, fun weapon that also has a little bit of humor hidden behind it as well. And finally, last on our list, I think it's about time I share what was arguably the most recommended weapon of last video, and quite possibly among the most amusing ballistic items ever featured in a Fallout game, the explosive minigun. As was the case for the never-ending double barrel, the explosive minigun is a legendary item that can only be found randomly on legendary characters throughout the game, and is exceptionally rare. Again, no matter how many legendaries we farm or how hard we try, there's no mathematical guarantee we'll ever find one of these. Nonetheless, it's still worth trying. As the name unsubtly suggests, the explosive minigun is a minigun with an explosive legendary effect applied. And this marriage is very much a harmonious one. At least it is if you're the one behind the barrel. A normal minigun does 8 points of damage per hit, with an otherwise unheard of fire rate of around 24 rounds a second, which alone is strong, but the explosive effect is going to cause every round of fire to detonate on impact, dealing a whopping 15 points of area of effect damage each, more than tripling the potential damage output of this beast. Assuming all of your bullets land, the explosive minigun can deal over 500 damage a second. Of course, even more with mods and perks. Furthermore, since we're working with area of effect damage, your rounds aren't even going to need to make absolute contact with the target in order to hurt. As long as a bullet explodes within about a yard of a creature, they'll take 15 points of that explosive damage, though won't be impacted by the normal 8 ballistic. This essentially works to negate the minigun's largest limitation, the item's inaccuracy. A large spread, recoil, and high rate of fire has always made the minigun a less than precise item. And depending on the distance you're working with, it's not uncommon to have a hit ratio of less than 40%. However, with this enchantment active, that becomes significantly less of a problem. Now, as mentioned, this minigun is exceptionally hard to come by, but fear not, because there is a somewhat similar weapon you can definitely get to hold you over while you farm legendaries and wait for this one to enter your game. Fahrenheit, Hancock's bodyguard and good neighbor, wields a special minigun variant called the Ashmaker. And while it's not explosive, it does have the incendiary effect, which will cause it to produce these beautiful orange tracers and inflict 15 extra points of fire damage on enemies, making it technically capable of dealing out as much pain as its explosive counterpart. Though, do note that its damage is fire, not explosive, meaning you won't get that important area of effect damage. Ashmaker can be obtained after completing the quest The Big Dig, and either killing or siding with Fahrenheit. So, while not as great, it is a guarantee. Nevertheless, if you really want one of the most lethal items to ever grace the Commonwealth, make sure you're confronting those legendary Deathclaws and Yao Guais as often as possible. It just may pay off. And with that, we are going to wrap up. 5 more secret, unique, or otherwise overlooked weapons in Fallout 4. Thanks for stopping by, everyone. If you like this video and would like to see more of them and join this sort of Skyrim / Fallout 4 nostalgia narrative community, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Also, which of these items did you find to be the coolest, and which should I cover if we get around to a part 3? Leave a comment down below. As always, like ratings are very much appreciated, and I hope to catch you all in my next video. Peace out, everyone.